for jamming. I wanna jam it with you.
Hey,
we're jamming, jamming, and I hope you like jamming too.
Hey guys, I went to watch the much anticipated, well, at least I was anticipating it, the Bob Marley biopic, Bob Marley One Love. And look, while it was very entertaining, as biopics go, it was pretty average. The movie celebrates the life and music of the iconic Jamaican singer-songwriter. It specifically focuses on the period between 1976 and 1978, leading up to his One Love Unity concert in Jamaica, which was meant to facilitate peace between two clashing political parties. So I'm not a huge Bob Marley fan, but I can absolutely appreciate his legendary status. And even as someone who isn't that big of a fan, I still felt like this movie didn't quite do him justice. It gives you a glimpse into his life, and I think that was my issue. It literally felt like just a glimpse. I felt like they could have given a fuller picture of his life. Much of the focus was on the music, which was incredible, by the way, I'll get to that later, and his rise to fame in Europe. But not as much attention was paid to his actual life story. To be fair, they did try to give us more about his life beyond that two-year period between 1976 and 78 by using flashbacks. And that is where it became problematic for me, because the flashbacks were a distraction and actually pulled me out of the story as opposed to serving it. I mean, their placement was odd. The chronology was strange. First, they gave us baby Bob, and then adult Bob, and then back to teenage Bob, and then we're baby Bob. I'm like, oh, guys. And then it made the movie feel disjointed and incohesive. And then they had these weird recurring, I don't know, dream sequences or visions. Man, at that point, I was just scratching my head. I was confused. I also think that they played it safe in terms of showing the parts of Bob Marley's life that were not so savory. A lot of it was implied or just glossed over, where you were like, whoa, wait, what? Okay. I had to Google Bob Marley just to get clarity on some of the things that I saw on screen.
Bob Marley mystery?
Whoa! I was not ready for that tea. I mentioned the music earlier, you guys. Yo! Listen, if you are a Bob Marley fan, waste no time. Go get your ticket now. Because, oh, the music in this movie is outstanding. The concert scenes, the studio session scenes, scenes with Bob Marley just singing with his guitar. I mean, it was amazing. It was a real celebration of his music, but also the message behind his music. It was outstanding. And then the casting. Look, casting for a biopic is not easy, but they absolutely nailed it in this movie. Yo! Kingsley Ben-Adir. Guys, he was mesmerizing. Ha! Like, I believed. I genuinely believed that he was Bob Marley. He completely transformed and became the icon. Look at this. His voice, his accent, the inflection in his voice, his movement. Oh my word, especially when he was performing. His singing even. He didn't sing all the songs, but there were definitely songs that he sang. And I was just like, I mean, well, yeah, I know. Job well done. Unbelievable. Well, believable. This one is a saunter to your nearest cinema. They could have given us a better picture of Bob Marley's life, but the music is fantastic and it is enjoyable, and I think it is worth a watch. So do go and see Bob Marley, One Love.